Good morning to all of you, and welcome to the Heart and Soul programs of India Bridge to Life Family Counseling Ministry. We thank God for the year of 2019 and these days. God is so faithful to us. We are going to see the new era and new areas of our life in the year of 2019. Of course, we have to respect God and respect each other. What is a key word we have to use this year should be like respect each other. Our father of nation, Gandhiji, he once met our greatest guru in this country, is Tagore, Rabindranath Tagore. Once they met each other, so they look at each other. The Tagore, the greatest poet who could sense the worth of a person, he said to, by looking the face of Gandhiji, "Sir, you are a Mahatma. You are a Mahatma." He respected Mahatma. He adored Mahatma. He identified the worth of that person. Then he called, by looking the face of Mahatma Gandhiji, "You are a Mahatma." Yes, you are an extraordinary personality. Your leadership is so wonderful. You have sacrificed many things for others. So therefore, life is so beautiful for you in that sense. You are a great man. When Gandhiji listened to that poem, he looked at the face of this great teacher, greatest teacher, who got the Nobel Prize for Literature. And he looked at his face and say, "Rabindranath Tagore, you are the greatest guru in India now. You have something in your heart to teach the people of our country now." So this is a mutual respect. When we come to the point of faith, we can understand about the John Baptist. He came to this world to prepare the way of the Lord. That was our last week discussion. So when we are continuing with that discussion, we know these two personalities, Jesus and John the Baptist, they respected each other. They loved each other. Jesus is six months younger than to John the Baptist. They were relatives. And the mother of Jesus, Mary, she visited Elizabeth when Elizabeth had that 6 month pregnancy. So they greeted each other. They rejoiced and stamped together. The mothers, they both respected each other. For Elizabeth, she was a very old woman, but for Maria, a very young girl. So both are in the same position to bring the good news to this world. So God chosen these two families. One family was very old family. Another family also is about to have an institution called family. They want to have a union. But before that, many things are happening in these families. The first we are talking about this John the Baptist family. So God planned the life of John the Baptist, and he was the last prophet according to the scripture, because God appointed the Old Testament prophets. So he was the last Old Testament prophet. He speak on behalf of God to the people. So during his time, what actually happened? Many things happened. That's what the Word of God says. Many will rejoice and gladness at the time of his birth. And he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He will be great in the sight of the Lord, and shall neither drink wine nor any hard drinks. And he will turn many of the children to the Lord. And he will go before the Spirit and turn the heart of the fathers to the children. Many broken families. The fathers are actually wandering, and they have an extra marital relationship. So he will, his messages, his methods will turn all these people back to the family, back to the family, back to the Lord, back to the Lord, back to the family. That was the greatest mission God has given to the John the Baptist. So it is not a simple effort. It is a high effort. To talk to a person, convince a person is not a human work actually. People are standing with their own selfish motives, self-interested things. How can they turn to God by sacrificing many of their egoist programs? Here this Word of God says that, but he can do it. He can change the situation and even the disobedient to the wisdom of the just. So that means John the Baptist is going to influence the culture of the people, the character of the people, the way of life of the people. That means he may be the most influential person in his generation. This is the greatest promise God had given to the father, Zechariah. Zechariah was the greatest priest. But the problem happened, and the verse 18 says, and Zechariah said to the angel, how shall I know this? For I am an old man, and my wife is well advanced in years. That means she is too old to carry a baby. So it was a shocking moment. The angel never expected that Zacharias would respond like this. He immediately asked a question, how shall I know this? This is a major problem in the world of believers. They will always question God, when? I want to know it. I want to know the timing. Maybe we can say it is a curiosity. But what will happen to his life? And the angel answered and said to him, I am Gabriel. I am Gabriel who brings always the good news to the people. I am Gabriel who stand in the presence of God. That is the highest post for an angel. I stand in the presence of God. So bring that into your mental picture. God is sitting in the throne. No one can see his face. He was full of power. So this angel Gabriel saw the God. That means he always see the reality. He was seeing the truth, the full of truth, full of power, full of spirit. So this man never tells even a single lie in his life, because he is an angel by his position. Second one, he is dealing with the reality. He is dealing with the God Almighty. If any person tells a lie, how could he stand and stood before God? They cannot do it. But in a human way, this Zechariah, the greatest priest, says, how shall I know about it? That was a black spot, a black point, a black things happen in his spiritual realm. in his spiritual life. God never expected, angel never expected. That's what God said to him, I am Gabriel who stand in the presence of God and was sent to speak to you and to bring you these glad tidings. What all I told you are glad tidings for you, glad news for you. But behold, you will be mute and not able to speak until the day these things take place. This is a small punishment for you. These things will happen, but until that moment, you will be like a dumb person. You are not going to speak on the things here. Because of his unfaith, he wanted to see the things immediately. He wanted to pressurize God. So these are the sum of the elements, our disbeliefs. Even though we were praying, he was praying for getting a child. He knows that the time is over, the capacity is over, everything is over. But now the God brings this goodness to this man, Zacharias. But Zacharias, the priest, by according to his position itself, he should believe it. And moreover, there is impossibility for bearing a child. But God proclaimed this is going to happen. But he wanted to know, how shall it happen? I want the detail about it. So questioning God is personally, it is not a bigger thing. But at the time of the God's intervention, he saw angel. Angel was standing before him. Then why should he raise this unnecessary question? God has pleased with this man. God wanted to help him in all his troubles. But even in the midst of this moment also, he was expressing his unrestness, what we call impatience before God. And because of that, he got this punishment from the God Almighty. You will be mute and not able to speak for a time. Until the time, all things will be finished and fulfilled. And the people waited in Zacharias coming from the temple inside. I marveled that he lingered so long in the temple. And when he came out, he could not speak to them. When he came out from the inner side of the temple to the outer side, he was unable to speak anything to the people. And they perceived that he had seen a vision in the temple. He beckoned to them and remained speechless. And after that, how did he manage? So he write it in a paper. So it was as soon as the days of his service were completed, then he departed to his own home. After those days, his wife conceived. And she hid herself 5 months, saying, thus the Lord has dealt with me in the days when he looked on me to take away my reproach among people. She was very happy. So during this time, the Mary visited Elizabeth, the old woman, old auntie. The verse 39 says, now Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country and hastened to the city of Judah and entered the house of Zachariah and greeted Elizabeth. So when Elizabeth heard the greetings of Mary, that the babe leaped in her womb and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. I'm wondering, because the child in the Mary's womb was the reason for giving the Holy Spirit to Elizabeth and John the Baptist. The Lord is a Lord forever, wherever He is. And the presence of this God that actually influenced them. So he said, but why is this granted to me that the mother of my Lord should come to me? She should immediately recognize, who is this Mary now? Maybe she is related to her. But she said, what she said is, that the mother of my Lord should come to me. What a great things happened in my life. And indeed, as soon as the voice of your greeting sounded in my ears, the babe leaped into my womb for joy. When the mother of Jesus, Mary, spoke to Elizabeth, the voice was sufficient to make the baby to respond. He was in full of joy. So this is the connectivity between these two people and two families. If there are two families, they were filled with the Holy Spirit, they have the godly intervention, what will happen? They have more joy in their life. So this is a thing the Word of God is talking to us. And also says, many will rejoice at the birth of John the Baptist, because he'll be born as a child who bring the gladness to the people around them. So this is a common factor sometimes. There are people who are born in many villages. Once upon a time, there are a lot of scientists, they visited to a place and asked them a question. And says about it, do you know that any greatest people born in this village? They said, we will inquire about it. So each person moved around in the small village and they exchanged this question, this idea. Did any great man born in this village? They say no. Only kids are born in this village. Maybe in future, they may be great. But no one is born as great. Maybe some people say some are born as great because they're born in a great family. The children of Queen Elizabeth in England become great in their at the time of their birth because they are inheriting a great tradition. People accepted them. They will get a higher position always because they're born as great. And there are some other people, they're born in an ordinary family, but they'll be great because of their hard work. Ambani was born in a very small family, working as a clerk in Oman. Later he came back to India. He established a business kingdom. Now he's no more, but his children are the two top people in that kingdom. So there are people, those who are doing hard work and they are become great. But there are some other people, they are great because others are weak. Especially in a democratical situation, this is happening. Because there's many are in a weak position. Therefore, many can become great. This is a Word of God, we are talking about it. And the birth of John the Baptist was a great incident, great event, happened at the time of Jesus, period. So, when Zacharias asked the question, Zacharias was unable to speak until the birth of John the Baptist. So, this is what we need to understand that we need to understand the power of Jesus in our life. But come to another family, is Mother Mary. How did Mother Mary respond to this situation? She was rejoiced in the presence of God because the same Gabriel, sent by the same God, to announce the most important words to a virgin girl, Mary. So we know that this is a you talk about Christ's birth announced to Mary, that also written the same chapter. So this is talking about Gabriel was sent by God to a city called Galilee in Nazareth. In Luke chapter 1 verse 26 says, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of the devil, the virgin's name was Mary. So this is a direct dealing with Mary and the Lord Almighty. The communicator was Gabriel. He always bring the glad news from the Lord to the people. And the virgin was already betrothed. They had decided to marry together. And having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among the women." The blessed are you among all the women. So God's selection, God chosen you. You are going to be a great woman. But when he saw the angel, she was troubled and saying, and consider what manner of greeting this was. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. You have found favor with God, and behold, you will conceive your womb and bring forth a son and shall call his name Jesus." So before the birth of John, the angel Gabriel told the God's plan and they put the name John. And also at the before the birth of Jesus Christ, before conceiving Jesus Christ in the womb, God told his name Jesus. So greatest men are living in this way. God already made a plan for their birth. And God also put a name for these people. Even today, many micro-sized families, we know, before the marriage itself, or before the birth of the child, they decided to put a name for their children. So, because they are because the children are born from their own intensive desire. Even modern family, I'm talking. Because even people are afraid that whether the pregnancy will take place. Therefore, they are looking for a chance to get it conceived and to put a name for the child little earlier after the marriage. Here all God says, this is the same thing to that. Don't be afraid. The God has a favor with you. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God will give him a throne of his father David. So when I am thinking of this portion, God is concerned about the tradition. Tradition. What's the tradition? The family traditions. God already remembered the families. The God of David. He promised, you will have a son forever. Somebody will be sitting in your throne. Somebody will be the king forever. So according to that genealogy, Jesus born in the same tradition. So Mary was a person from a Levite family. They are supposed to give offerings and sacrifice to God. Yet we can see that the word of God says, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. Again connections. From David's chair, the throne. But family-wise, the house of Jacob. And his kingdom, there will be no end. Jesus is going to establish a kingdom with no end. This is the greatest promise to a mother Mary, a young girl. She was selected, chosen by God. God was very clear in communication. God talked to this mother Mary. This is what is going to happen. Though you are a young girl, the better things I would say later, no. Now itself I would say, what is going to happen? The same way John the Baptist's life also. He will be like this. He will be great. He will turn father to children. He will turn the disobedient to the just. So he will turn ungodly to godly. So God explained the life missions of the greatest man, John the Baptist. Same way, The same Gabriel told to the Jesus, the mission of Jesus to Mother Mary. He said, definitely he will be going to establish a kingdom forever, no end. Greatest promise to a mother. So mother said to the angel the same question, how can I sense it since I do not know a man? This is not an unfaith. I am ready, but how can it possible? I want to know the detail about it. So this question is different from the question raised by the Zacharias the priest and the father Abraham. That too came out with a lot of negative aspects, but this question is come out from many positive approach. So angel answered and said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the highest will be overshadow you. Therefore also the Holy One who is to be born will be calling the Son of God. So this is the way he became a Son of God. This is the way Jesus became a Son of God. Because Father Almighty, the God the Almighty, is the reason for his birth. Not a human way, but in a godly way. So what we are trying to say is this. If God has a plan, God will use many unthinkable in human sense. God made a plan to save and to establish things in the world. Therefore, the worldly pattern is not the outcome of our human thoughts. The worldly things are going not with the human wisdom, but it is fully depend on the godly wisdom which will operate by God himself. So in this morning, I want to tell you to come up, line up in the way of God, so that many extraordinary miracles may happen through your family life. May God bless you with this message and continue to minister to your people. So thank you so much for watching today's Heart and Soul program. Thank you so much. Bye. Shanti.